You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. Our top story today, with interest rates expected to go up this week after the U.S. Federal Reserve's policy meeting on June 14th, analysts expect Taiwan's central bank to convene a board meeting on June 16th to follow suit and hike interest rates from 0.125 to 0.25 percentage points. In response to the forecast, the TAIEX plummeted 350 points upon opening today.
After the central bank hiked interest rates by 0.25 percentage points in March, experts predicted further hikes were coming. The central bank will convene a board meeting on June 16th as it looks to combat surging inflation and narrow the interest rate gap. Experts say the U.S. will make the first move during central bank super week with an interest rate hike of 0.5 to 0.75 percentage points. The scale of the Fed's hike will be a benchmark for Taiwan's central bank, but experts don't expect a hike of more than 0.25 percentage points.
目前的利率都还在2%以下，整体来讲对消费的压力力道差异性不会太大。房贷族为主啦，很少说真的，我平常日常消费，我真的会去贷款做消费。After
the Dow's major setback on June 10th, the TAIEX plummeted 350 points upon opening on the 13th, at one point falling close to 400 points.
卖压都是来自于电子金融券这些的股票，外资的一个操作，今年恐怕会大幅调节台股，短线来看的话，还没有止跌的一个讯号。
Experts say this year's consumer price index will be around 3%, with inflationary pressure remaining high.
Today, grassroots groups of police officers and firefighters convened a press conference to ask the Directorate General of Personnel Administration to set an upper limit on working hours and listen to their suggestions.
Firefighters always do their best to put out fires. Police officers are usually deployed to keep demonstrations orderly. Police officers and firefighters often have to work overtime due to the requirements of their jobs. Constitutional Interpretation No. 785 ruled that a review of relevant health-related provisions on personnel with special work characteristics was necessary, including an upper limit on the number of working hours. Although the legislature passed the third reading of amendments to related laws at the end of May, it authorized agencies to set the upper limit for working hours. Now, grassroots police officers and firefighters are calling on the Directorate General of Personnel Administration to set a uniform standard.
我们都是人，我们都有自己的家庭，我们都有自己身体的极限。那为什么我们的工时上限却可能会由机关自己定出一个不同的工时上限？这应该是由人事总处有一个中央的机构统一去定定，身为一个人、一个公务员，我们的最高的工时上限。
On June 8th, the DGPA invited public officials to discuss health-related plans, but did not invite representatives from government functionary groups to participate, so they did not hear the voices of grassroots functionaries.
如果你没有倾听基层的意见的话，那你不管怎么修这些原则都会有问题。像是警政署现在已经开始在试行的修法之后原则，例如说那个。 月工时上限或者是休息时间间隔，就算你勤务这样规划，但是实际上在工还是把它直接召回，就等于直接有黑数工时的状况。The
DGPA responded that it will continue reviewing the work and rest system and a reduction in the number of working hours. It hopes to achieve a system that protects health and business operations and that will be accepted by workers. The National Fire Agency is working on a two-shift system for 2022 with three-year cycles. The objective is to add one rest day per month. The DGPA said it will communicate with all parties to listen to opinions.
And now we'll bring you some of the top stories from around the nation. Yunlin County planned to resume physical classes on June 13th, but announced that online classes would continue until the 17th last night. The county government said this was at the behest of close to 70% of surveyed parents. One expert says PCR values can be used to settle the cremation deadline controversy. The Ministry of Health and Welfare says it may lift funeral restrictions if disease prevention measures remain in place. The Taoyuan City Councilor says many road and traffic signs are obstructed from view by foliage, and periodic inspections are needed to ensure road safety. The number of people testing positive for COVID-19 in this current wave has already surpassed 1 million. Many of the cases are reinfections, including a nurse who caught COVID-19 three times over the course of a year, with each case more severe than the previous one.
The epidemic situation in Taiwan shows no signs of slowing. It is believed that for people who recover from COVID-19, immunity can last about 3 months. The Central Epidemic Command Center recently even said that people who recover have invincible immunity and won't get reinfected, so they won't be listed as contacts or have to quarantine. However, there is the case of a nurse who got infected on three separate occasions over the course of a year. Each case was more severe than the previous one.
人的一个免疫系统，在体内其实跟我们的遗传基因都有影响，有的人就是先天对某一类的病菌特别有抵抗力，有些人就对某一类就特别没有抵抗力，像有一些得到所谓无敌星星以后再感染疫的这个事情，这个的确是会发生。奥密克戎的病毒特性已经变了，比较容易逃脱免疫，所以很多的抗体就无法抵抗它。
According to CECC statistics, there are 1,212 people who have gotten infected twice since 2020. There is no consensus yet on whether the symptoms of a second infection are milder. Doctors say the belief that reinfection won't occur within 3 months' time probably only applies to the exact same sequence. The virus infected too many people after it started spreading at the community level, so there will be sequence replication errors. If the sequence differs, then reinfection can occur. This is specific to the Omicron variant.
你过去染疫，然后现在是无敌星星，已经没有这件事情了。Omicron它这个 BA.1.2.3.4.5，还有 BA.2.有这么多的一个亚型，其实只要序列差异的有点大，然后对方二度感染你的人他的病毒浓度是高的话，你都还是会被感染。Doctors
remind the public that COVID-19 is harmful, especially to those with chronic illnesses. Those with breathing difficulties and palpitations even after recovery from COVID-19 should seek medical treatment to determine if there is pulmonary fibrosis and medications are needed.
A woman in her 30s delivered a baby boy in Kaohsiung on June 6th. However, 5 days later, when he was transferred to a postnatal care center, he tested positive for COVID-19. No one he had contact, including hospital workers and his parents, tested positive, and it now remains unknown how he got infected.
A nurse outfitted in personal protective gear from head to toe enters the hospital while patients have their temperature checked at the door. A week-old infant delivered at the hospital was taken to a postnatal care center on the 11th and tested positive during check-in. The infant had never left the neonatal unit at the hospital or shared a room with his parents before then. It remains unknown how he got infected, as his parents, other infants in the neonatal center, and all hospital workers that came into contact with him have all had negative PCR tests.
这中间五天他都没有出婴儿室，我们现在规定婴儿，目前都会留在婴儿室，没有跟爸爸妈妈见面。
The hospital says the boy has a CT value of 26, which means his viral load isn't particularly high. His parents have never had COVID, so the only plausible theory is that he got infected at the hospital.
目前的传染途径我们也都还在厘清，因为全部的有可能接触的工作人员，我们都第一时间做快筛加PCR，都是阴性。也没办法怎么样，就是大家自己在
The city government says the infant is currently in the ICU at a medical center and in stable condition. Two other newborns that were in the same neonatal unit have both tested negative. The hospital will continue monitoring their conditions and hopes to have answers on how the boy got infected soon.
And now we're bringing some top stories from around the world. European Commission President visited wounded soldiers being treated in Kyiv and said the EU executive's opinion on the country's request to join the EU will be ready by the end of next week. A bipartisan group of U.S. senators announced on June 12th that it has agreed on a framework for potential legislation on gun safety, including tougher background checks for firearm buyers under 21. United States gasoline prices, a key driver of the highest inflation seen in the U.S. in 40 years, hit a record of $5 a gallon on June 11. Taichung reported 7,734 new domestic cases in Taiwan on June 12, which is the highest in Taiwan. Meanwhile, more and more Taichung residents are seeking help for long COVID symptoms, including brain fog and respiratory issues.
Taichung Veterans General Hospital has treated 20 long COVID cases in the past 3 months. All of the patients were 6 months removed from having COVID-19. Some reported brain fog, while others were dealing with respiratory issues. Most showed improvement with integrative treatment after 2 or 3 appointments.
那你注意力不集中，容易倦怠来讲，会就会影响到自己的工作、自己的家庭跟自己的人际关系。那如果是一个以呼吸系统为主的症状的话，那对于运动活动就会比较有呼吸困难的情形。
Long COVID refers to long-term consequences after recovery from the initial infection, with symptoms ranging from anxiety, depression, insomnia, brain fog, and cognitive dysfunction to respiratory issues, pulmonary fibrosis, arrhythmia, and multisystem inflammation. Taichung reported 7,734 new domestic cases on the 12th, the highest in Taiwan. There are 15 hospitals in the city with long COVID clinics. One official expects the number of long COVID cases to peak in July or August.
在未来，我们这个这样子人可能会蛮多的，预计可能到七八月都会达到一个高峰期。那我们希望说，民众在感染过新冠以后，也不要掉以轻心。
The health bureau says 599 of Taichung's 1,378 COVID-19 beds are currently occupied. However, only 9 and 5 of the city's 109 adult and 23 children's ICU beds are available respectively. With medical capacity on the verge of collapse, officials are calling on everyone to remain careful and vigilant.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.